5. Air, water and weather. 1. Air and water. Hello dudes. Air is a precious resource that all of us take for granted and is important for almost all life on earth. Air supplies oxygen to us and many animals, which is essential for our bodies to live. Without air, we would survive only for a few minutes. Plants need other gases from the air to perform photosynthesis. Water is a transparent fluid which forms the world's streams, lakes, oceans, and rain. And it is the major constituent of the fluids of living things. Water on Earth moves continuously through the water cycle of evaporation, transpiration, condensation, precipitation, and runoff, usually reaching the sea. In this lesson, you will learn about the air and water.
Unit 5. Air, water and weather. 1. Air and water. We cannot live without air and water. They are necessary for living. All living beings die without air and water. We find air around us and water in the ground below us. Air. The earth is surrounded by a layer of air. This layer is called atmosphere. All living things need pure and fresh air for breathing. The atmosphere is full of gases. Oxygen gas in air helps to burn food in our body and gives us energy to do work.
We cannot see air, but we can feel air when it moves. Air is present everywhere. As we go higher from the earth, air decreases. That is why mountaineers carry oxygen cylinders with them.
Water. We use water for many purposes. We use water for cooking, drinking, bathing, washing, and for many other purposes.
We find water in oceans, rivers, lakes, wells, and ponds. It is also present in the bodies of all animals, plants, and human beings.
Properties of water. Water, as we see it every day, is in liquid form. It has no color, taste, or smell. But sea water is salty because there is salt in it. Water can be poured from one vessel into another. It takes the shape of the vessel in which it is kept. Liquids do not have definite shape. Water takes the shape of vessel.
Different forms of water. Water is a liquid. When we put out wet clothes to dry, the water from them goes into the air as water vapor and our clothes get dried up. This form of gas is called water vapor. Activity. Put a tray of water into the freezer and see after some time. Water is turned into ice. Ice is another form of water. It is solid. It has definite shape and does not flow. Ice is lighter than water and floats on water. Have you seen water boiling in a vessel on the stove?
Yes.
What comes out of the vessel?
Steam.
The changing of water into water vapor is called evaporation. Activity. Take a dry glass. Fill it with ice cubes. Observe after some time. After some time, you will see small drops of water forming on the outer surface of the glass. Where has this water come from? When the water vapor in the air touches the cold surface of the glass, it changes back into water. This changing of water vapor into water by cooling is called condensation. Thus, we see that ice, water, and water vapor are the three forms of water. In the form of ice or snow, solid. In the form of water, liquid. In the form of steam or water vapor, gas. Water changes from one form to another by heating or cooling. On heating, ice changes into water and water changes into water vapor. On cooling, water vapor changes into water and water changes into ice. Activity. Change the states of water in three forms. Three states of water. Let's revise the important points. 1. All living things need air and water to live. 2. We use water for many purposes. 3. We get water from oceans, rivers, lakes, and ponds. 4. Water exists in three forms: solid, liquid, and gas. 5. Changing of water into water vapor is called evaporation. 6. Changing of water vapor back to water is called